Dear students, in first session, what we discuss? We discuss the synthetic fibers and plastics. So in that, what is the introduction part? How the cloths are made? How it is made? So whatever the cloths are made of fabrics. The cloths are made of fabrics. So these fabrics are made from fibers. Actually, the fibers are classified into two major parts. One is natural fibers and another one is artificial fibers. The natural fibers are obtained from plants or animals. And the artificial fibers are man-made fibers or synthetic fibers. It can be manufactured. So these is the two major difference between natural fibers and artificial fibers. And next, the fibers is prepared. So after that, we have to do the spinning process. With that spinning process only, we can get the thread-like filament. So that thread-like filament, we can manufacture the cloths. And now we will discuss the difference between the natural fibers versus artificial fibers. The natural fibers are exist naturally. And artificial fibers do not exist naturally. And natural fibers are obtained from plants and animal sources. And the artificial fibers are obtained from man-made fibers. It is manufacturing fibers. It is synthetic fibers. And natural fibers are not possible to change the fiber structure. The structure cannot be changed in natural fiber. But in artificial fiber, the structure can be modified. The structure can be altered. We can easily modify the artificial fiber structure. And natural fibers are environment friendly. It is eco-friendly. And artificial fibers are not environment friendly. It is not eco-friendly. And natural fibers are more comfortable. When we wear the natural fiber cloths, for example, when we wear the cotton cloths, we can feel the comfort zone, and the prices are higher. So natural fibers are less, more comfortable and higher prices. But artificial fibers are less comfortable and the prices is lesser prices. When we compare with natural fiber, the artificial fibers cost is lesser. And so these cloths are used, the natural fibers are mostly used in clothing purpose only. It is used only for clothing. But the artificial fibers are used for various multiple purpose. It can be used as clothing purpose and it can be used as thread. So that the artificial fibers can be used in various multiple purpose. So these are the major difference between the natural fibers and artificial fibers. The natural fibers exist naturally. Artificial fiber do not exist naturally. It can be obtained from plants and animal sources. Artificial fibers are manufacturing fibers, so that we can tell it as man-made fibers or synthetic fibers. So here, the structure is not altered in natural fibers, but in artificial fiber, structure can be altered. And in natural fibers, it is eco-friendly, but in artificial fiber, it is not eco-friendly. The natural fibers is more comfortable and prices are higher. But in artificial fiber, it is less comfortable, but the prices are lesser. Unnatural fibers mostly used in clothing purpose only. It is used only for clothing purpose. But artificial fibers, it is used for multiple purpose. It can be used for clothing and it can be used in various types of multiple purpose. So these are the major difference between natural fibers and artificial fibers. So natural fibers are more comfortable and the prices are higher. Now recently the research work is going on the natural fibers, how we can reduce the prices. Why? Because of the natural fibers are more comfortable but the prices are higher. So now the research work is going on to reduce the pricing cost. If we reduce the pricing cost, so all of them can use the natural fibers clothing purpose. So that now the research work is going on in the natural fibers to reduce the pricing cost. And now we can recapitulate the session, first session. So actually the fibers can be classified into two major types. One is natural fibers and another one is synthetic fibers. So synthetic fibers can be named as man-made fibers and artificial fibers. So the natural fibers can be obtained from plants and animals. There are various examples are there: cotton, wool and silk. Cotton is obtained from plant, wool and silk is obtained from animals. And artificial fibers and man-made fibers, the examples are polythene, carbon, glasses. So these are the sources for artificial fibers. And there are various examples are there: rayon, nylon, polyester, acrylic. So these are the various examples for synthetic fibers. So in the bottom we can see the technological invention, that is various types of instruments are there. So these instruments are prepared by the recent synthetic fibers. And now we will ask one question, what we discussed earlier. The question is, a chain of single chemical units combined to form a large single unit is called. I will repeat the question once again. A chain of small chemical units combined to form a large single unit is called. So what is the answer? You can think and tell. What is the answer for that? Polymer or poly or polythene or none of the above. So which is the correct answer for this question? Students, what is the correct answer? Yes, the answer is A, polymer. So polymer is the answer for this question. And next, take page number 32. Students, take your book, take pen or pencil and take page number 32. So in that page you can see the table 3.1. That is artificial and natural fibers. So in that you have to write the answer, you have to fill the table. So what are that in the table? They mention serial number, name of the article and type of fiber, that is natural or artificial. First you can write the article coir. And second, you can write the article tree wood. And third, you can write the article wool. And fourth, you can write the article silk. And fifth one is nylon. And sixth one is rayon. And seventh one is polyester. So coir, tree wood, wool, silk, nylon, rayon, polyester. The coir is what type of fiber is? It is natural fiber or artificial fiber? So what is the answer for first? The coir is natural fiber or artificial fiber? Yes, it is natural fiber. It can be obtained from plants. And next is tree wood. Tree wood is natural fiber or artificial fiber? It is also a natural fiber. The tree wood is obtained from plants. And next is wool. So what type of fiber it is? Students, what is the answer? Yes, it is also the natural fiber. And fourth question, silk. So what is type of fibers it is? What is the type? What type it is? It's natural fiber or artificial fiber? Its type is wool. And next is silk. So what type of fiber it is? It is natural or artificial? It's also a natural fiber. And next is nylon. So nylon is a artificial fiber. And rayon. Rayon is also an artificial fiber. And next is polyester. So polyester is also an artificial fiber. The first four, that is coir, tree wood, wool, silk or natural fiber, and nylon, rayon and polyester are artificial fiber. Have you completed the written work in that book? Completed now, students? Do you have any doubts? If you have any doubts, we can clarify in the discussion session. And now, it is a wonderful conversation between the Swami Vivekananda and one foreign person, Britisher. So once a British man asked Swami Vivekananda, why can't you wear proper clothes to look like a gentleman? For that, Swami Vivekananda smiled and sighed. In your culture, a tailor makes a gentleman. But in our culture, a character makes us a gentleman. So that, students, what is important for us? Character is much more important than clothes. So, with this session, what we discuss? We'll discuss the difference between the synthetic fibers and natural fibers. And we will discuss the two different questions. So in that book, there is the question, there is one table is there now. In which page? In 32. You have to complete that table. Yes. Okay, students. See you on next class. Thank you.